was that him and his family were taken into several prisons, including the famous or the infamous prison at Tadmur. And in this prison, they were tortured and killed at the rate of 50 to 60 a day. At 50 to 60 a day, they were killed at that rate. So you can see where the pedigree, who taught who, what the father learned from the son, what the son learned from the father. And there Abu Ahmed told me this story that should send shivers down your spine. He said that they were executing us day by day. They didn't even know what our numbers were. They were just concerned about the numbers they were killing. And my number came. But because the brothers loved that I taught them Islam, what little of Islam I knew, I used to teach them. Whenever my number came, somebody took my place and was executed instead of me. When Abu Ahmed said that these very lands that he was in, the beautiful groves of trees of the olives, and as in you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by these olive trees, وَالتِّينِ وَالزَّيْتُونِ, he swears by the land of Isa alayhi salam, that by this land, he says, that all of mankind is in a loss. And he said, here, we hid from them many years ago. And now today, we stand here firm, shoulder to shoulder, with all of our brothers, rising up against the regime. Abu Ahmed has several sons and nephews and nieces, numerous in that region. So many of them have fought and been killed, but not one of them, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا, none of them changed. They remained firm and continued to stand up in the face of oppression. And I want to tell you something. So if there are any people here who think that the great regime of Bashar al-Assad are the defenders or the bastions of anti-imperialism, let me remind you of this. When I was held by the Americans in the Bagram detention facility in 2002, where I was being tortured and physically and violated and watched people being beaten to death, the Americans said to me, if you don't cooperate, we will send you to Syria. In 2002, in the beginning of the war on terror, that means that the Americans were working close, hand in glove with the regime of Bashar al-Assad. My colleague Asif Qureshi has already said the cases of several individuals who were extraordinarily renditioned by the US regime, by the US government, to the regime of Bashar al-Assad. This country that was supposed to be part of the axis of evil was working in cahoots with the regime of, with the United States of America. So be under no illusion at all that when it comes to the violation of human rights or any other rights, these regimes are masters in the arts of torture and abuse. One of the things, brothers and sisters, that you must understand, that though today Aleppo has fallen, the rest of Syria that's in the hands of the opposition is strong, ready to fight to the last moment.
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
And just remember this too, that we have our own heroes, and I mean from Britain, from the Western world, who are reporting daily, as you know, about the situation down in the ground. We have our brother Tawqir Toksas Sharif, who every day shows us through the work that he does in the refugee camps, in the schools, and in the hospitals, working alongside his wife, wishing nothing except the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
We have Muhammad,
Allahu Akbar!
Muhammad Shakil Shabir, who goes in and out under the bombs of the regime, fearing nothing, fearing not the blame of the blamer, coming and reporting to us about the money and the goods that we've spent in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trying to protect the people of Syria. And let me tell you something. When I used to be in the land of Syria, when I was in the area that I saw, I'd be proud of this British Muslim community. Because I would see British ambulances, British fire trucks, British garbage trucks, British doctors, British aid workers, all Muslims from this community here. One of the doctors who some of you would have known was Dr. Isa Abdullah, who was shaheed while he was treating patients. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept him.
Amen. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
And mashallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put Isa right, his brother is right here. His brother, Isa Abdullah's brother is right here, who was shaheed in Syria. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept him amongst the ranks of the highest of the shuhada.
Ameen.
Allahu Akbar. And of course, the person who you must all have heard about, our dear and beloved brother, Bilal Abdul Karim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect him.
Ameen.
Who's been beaming live right from inside Aleppo. As you heard the bombs, he told me this as I was speaking to him before I just arrived here, and inshallah I hope if we can get hold of him. He hasn't slept for 2 days. You could hear the bombs falling in the background. You could hear the shells landing. You could hear the mortars whistling down as they landed and exploded. He said you can't walk in a street or see a building except that it hasn't been destroyed, or a wall that hasn't got bullet holes in it, or where you don't see blood pouring in the streets. And he's been in a place where nobody else, no Western journalist, dares to stay and report from. These are our heroes that nobody wants to talk about, that nobody says is part of the mainstream media, because the mainstream media, unfortunately, is riddled with cowardice. Bilal said to me that, and think about this, brothers, think about this, sisters, that everyone, the British, the Americans, the Turks, the Jordanians, the Gulf Arabs, the Iranians, the Russians, the Syrian regime, all of them have been bombing somewhere in Syria. When was the last time that Britain, France, America, and Russia all bombed on the same side? World War II. And what we're seeing is the greatest massacre of people since World War II. Except the difference is here this time, there's nobody coming to help. Except the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bilal told me this. When the Syrian people rose in the streets and said, Ma lana ghayrak ya Allah, Ma lana ghayrak ya Allah, that we have none but you, O Allah. He said to me that they expected that the bombs would be dropping and today was going to be our last day, we would be finished today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, send down from the heavens water and rain and the clouds that covered. And he said, as a result of the rain clouds,